Hello guys, welcome to the software testing tips and tricks channel. In last video we have learned about the Xpaths. So if you haven't seen that video, please see. In this video we have discussed about what is Xpath, types of Xpath, how to find Xpath manually, and different Xpath access and functions. So in that video I also gave live demonstration on how to find Xpath manually. So finding Xpath manually is sometimes consume time and sometimes may not be efficient. So there are some Xpath tools available freely. We can use that and make our automation script writing process faster. So let's start. So before start, just subscribe this channel, and if you are QA, then tell about what you want to learn in comments, and you can subscribe this channel, press bell icon, go through videos, and also share it to your QA friends. Thank you for supporting. So let's go through some Xpath tools. So there are plenty of Xpath tools are available in the market. So which Xpath tool to use? So first, when you go to App Store or you are searching in Google, just make sure the Xpath tool is updated recently and what support it provides, and if you have they have screenshot or video, go through that. Because whatever automation Xpath tool you are using along with your automation to just get the Xpath, you have to trust that Xpath. So once you started trusting that tool, your automation process will become smoother. So see, this Xpath tool is not updated since long. I started using this Xpath tool. This is named Xpath Helper. So this Xpath tool is something it provides some black window from extension. You have to enable this. So when you press shift button and select your elements, it started generating Xpath and puts here. You can copy that and use, but it looks similar, looks like static Xpath only or absolute Xpath only. So this is same as go to inspect, copy and copy Xpath from developer tools. So second tool I found which is quite popular is Xpath Finder. So Xpath Finder has so many users, and this tool is something tricky to use based on the screenshot if you see. So how to use? Just enable that. Go to website and copy on the click on the image or button or whatever element you want to find. Here in bottom right it gives that Xpath and copies to your clipboard. So it is copied. Now you can directly paste it your Xpath to your script. But this tool also I found sometimes and not giving proper results. So if you go to this Google search, it is creating Xpath which is kind of static. So sometimes it not work, but this is also one of the tool which gives you Xpath quickly. Other Xpath tool I found on Firefox, which is called TruePath. It is I think in Chrome also, but in Firefox I used to use that. So this Xpath, just you need to right click on your element, and it will suggest a few Xpath, this one, you can use this one, you can use this one, and it recommended based on that. So you can use okay, you find this one attractive, you can use that, and you can use option to copy from here, and it will tell you it contains iframe or not. It because one of the limitations with browsers developer tools are it don't tell you when you write this Xpath, it don't tell you it is inside iframe or not. So this tool will give you that information, okay, it's inside iframe, so you have to handle that. So this is a quite simple tool, but for more advanced tool I find is Chropath and SelectorHub. So this Chropath and SelectorHub use case varies and looks pretty similar. So Chropath is updated on April, and SelectorHub is updated recently. Also, like I went through both tools, and I find like SelectorHub provides Xpath, which is more relative, and it has like good support as well. So let's go like how this SelectorHub works. So I am using SelectorHub from last couple of months. So when you right click, it will give option selective hub, and you can copy your Xpath. So one of the way to use that. Second way is like this is pretty fast way. Like when you trust your tool, just click right click and copy that Xpath and paste what it has generated here. But sometimes like using console is not good. So in console it provides one more tab for SelectorHub. So it is like it has so many functionalities. So whatever Xpath you have copied, you can paste here and verify. Or you have, if you have written Xpath manually, you can paste here and verify. Because what happens, we all have tendency to put our Xpath, whatever we find is in browser's developer tools. So when we press here and write A, so it generates so many results, right? So it generates this API one also. So this is not our anchor tag, but this is part of URL, and it counts the scripts as one of the Xpath. But if you are trying here, so it will give you 279 results, which all are anchor tags only. See, AHREF1 only. So if someone asks you to write a script which gives number of links, and if you write just let's say, and you go to confirmation here, then this guy may mislead you, and you have to write more appropriate query for Xpath. So here like you can verify like this. It will give also like if you want to find with text, ID, class, name, placeholder. Also like real Xpath you want to find, CSS selector you want, DOM element you want. So all this you can find. Like DOM also, to verify DOM on this browser tool is hard. So this all information this tool gives, and it has plenty of options you can go through. Other thing I like about this tool is their studio. So it has something called this test case name, so you can start that. So this will start once you start going through your site. So my test case is click on this and open this thing and share button, right? So it will generate all the Xpath of that flow. So I can just perform my script I want to write. Like I want to write click on this button and login form, then it will give me all the Xpath needed for that script. So I just need to copy those Xpaths and put in my script. So this is very useful thing I found with this tool. So I think you will get like how to use Xpath tools and how to find good Xpath tools. You can use based on comfort level. So the main thing you need to focus is whatever Xpath this tool gives me. So this tool gives me this Xpath for this breaking news button, right? So this Xpath, how much I can trust on that? So putting this Xpath in my script will not make any issue in future. So you have to find the tool which gives you optimum and good Xpath. So when you start using that tool, first like confirm with your automation or manual knowledge. Okay, this Xpath looks good, and manually also if I have write this this Xpath, it would be almost same. So after writing few scripts, you get trust on that tool, and you blindly just copy and paste your Xpath in your script and you can write hundreds of scripts in a month. So those are some Xpath tools I went through, and there are some general queries. first thing is, why should we use Xpath tools? So as I told, like, it will make automation process faster. You will get absolute Xpath. When you are new to Xpath and you don't, no one is help you to find Xpath, those tools are there. So you can use tools to make yourself comfortable writing scripts when you don't know how to find Xpath manually. But as I suggested, first find the Xpath manually and then compare with tool, and if his tool is giving you Xpath correct every time, then blindly trust that tool and start using that tool very efficiently. So second is, what if Xpath found by tools are wrong? So yeah, those are tools, and those runs with some basic logic. So what you need to check is, like, if your tool is giving Xpath wrong, so you can identify with what kind of thing it is giving wrong Xpath. So one thing you can do with wrong Xpath, if it is finding every time with something like for some kind of buttons or some kind of flows, and you identify that, you can go their support and ask, like, why this tool, I am using your tool and this tool is giving me some of the problems. Like, in most of their websites they have support thing. So for example, this SelectorHub has their support channels, and you can ask them in social media or contact on Telegram, Slack, so they will answer. So other tools may support or may not support. So if tools are getting updated recently, then there are higher chance that they are supporting that. So other thing is, like, if you are using that tool, so all the tools are, I think, freeware. So if you are using these tools like SelectorHub or any other tool you find comfortable, and it is making your work lighter, or it is helping you much, then feel free to donate them. So other thing is, like, what if Xpath find tools are wrong? So other thing you can do is, like, you can change your tool. Yeah, so there are plenty of tools available. If you are not comfortable with any tool or you are not trusting that tool, just change it. What about testing feature generation? So this is the question by management, like, when they find, like, okay, these guys are using automation tools to get the Xpath, and they come up with, like, okay, if new guy is starting using their tools directly, he will not learn how to find it manually, and generation we will forget that, like, how to find Xpath manually. Will that happen? May or may not be, because for all the tools it is same. Like, when tools comes, it simplifies our life, right? So this may happen or may not happen, but all tools are simplify our life. So that doesn't mean we should not use tool, but if we keen to learn, like, basics of that thing, then we can use the tools efficiently. So that's much in this video. Thank you guys for watching this. For any doubt, feel free to comment, like and share this video to your QA community, and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you for supporting.